Hi, welcome to this session. So if you remember, in the previous session we are discussing about few voluntary standards like fair trade, rainforest alliance. So we'll continue our discussion on few more voluntary standards, and then we'll say what is the business case for adopting a sustainability standard. So the new the other sustainability standard what is there is that organic. It developed in 1970s and it is based on IFOAM basic standard. And what it provides or what it related to? It related to the framework for framework of minimum requirement, including the omission of agrochemical or such as pesticide and chemical synthetic fertilizer. Use of animal feed is also strictly regulated. And use of GMOs, that is genetically modified organism, are also forbidden. Organic is one of the earliest sustainability standard which developed in 1970s, and it is mostly on how to bring the organic attributes of the product by less using or not using pesticide, chemical and also the other restriction. Then the other voluntary sustainability standard is sustainable tourism. It includes standard for sustainable hotels, sustainable tour operators, sustainable event and conference, and sustainable destination. So you'll find there are many ISO standards which is related to sustainable hotels, specifically about sustainable events. So there is a specific ISO standard which is for the sustainable events and also the conferences and also the sustainable hotels. With so you will find that hotel certified with ISO 14001, which is the green hotel or the eco-friendly hotel or the sustainable hotel. Then there is a United Nations Forum on Sustainability Standard known as UNFSS, is a joint initiative of FAO, UNEP, ITC, UNTAC and also UNIDO on sustainable standard. So this is a neutral and credible platform to maximize the potential of voluntary sustainability standard, that is VSS, because this is used as a means to achieve the sustainable development goals. So there are many more voluntary standards, voluntary sustainability standards. We have just selected few to understand what it is relevant for and where it is related, like Rainforest Alliance or your fair trade or organic or let us say sustainable tourism. Let us then see gets into that. So we know that there are lot of standards available, ISO and also the other voluntary standards, and the role of the standards in the sustainability journey is that provide a framework which will help in reducing the impact and achieve the sustainable development. So there are many more standards that is linked to our sustainable development goals. But the bigger question what comes for the corporate and from the for the organization is that if we adopt a standard, what next or what are we going to get it? Because adopting a standard is not free. There is a substantial amount of investment associated in adopting a standard or following a framework or following a system. So here we have just taken a case or case example of a case study of Tata Global Beverage, which was published in BSI site, that is in the BSI case study of Tata Global Beverage. And to explain or to understand that by adopting a standard, how it leads to the business performance or what kind of benefit or what kind of profit the organization will get when they are adopting the standard. So this specific case study taken from BSI, it illustrates how certification to several management system standard has helped drive the business efficiency and cost saving at an award winning factory. So because of this adoption of this standard or certification of this different standards, how it has helped for increasing their business efficiency and also at the same time getting the benefit of the cost saving. Now coming to the Tata Global Beverage, this is the profile of the organization. This is the second largest tea company in India, and it has a turnover of $1.4 billion, and also this is 3000 employee worldwide. The headquarter is in the UK, and it has a factory in Eagles Cliff, Teesside, as well as plants in India, Russia and Czech Republic, and joint venture in US and Poland. They have 215 million serving of its brand are consumed every day around the globe. Now, when it comes to their sustainability standard or the other standards, they hold the multiple standard. So, one of the premier one is that, or the important one is that ISO 9001, what they are holding since many years, that is 9001 quality management. Similarly, ISO 14001 environmental management, ISO 50001 that is energy management, specifically for energy management, then BSOH SAS 18001 for the occupational health and safety. Now, if you look at, if you try to understand the viewpoint of the leaders of these companies, leaders and the managers, this is how they bring out that what, how the standards are helping them, or what kind of profit or what kind of benefit they are getting. So, these are few of the statement what have been taken from their statement what have been taken from their interview or from their statement, that how they bring or how they give the importance, or how they use to express that what is the role of standards in achieving the business efficiency. So, one is business tool to drive performance. So, this is a business tool. The standards act as a business tool to drive performance. This is a framework to formalize business. Then ISO 14001 gave the organization a clear directional path and a structure, help to maintain the best practices. The audit process ensure the organization is on track with the standard, and to ensure the policy and procedures are robust. So, if you look at, in one way, the way they are bringing out the role of standard in their different activity, in one way they are coming to the end goal that it is helping them to drive the performance, it is helping them to formalize the business, but also what standard is giving them in their business process is that it is giving framework, it is giving path, it is giving a structure, it is helping to maintain the best practices, and also the audit process associated with the standard, ensuring that the organization is on track with the standard, and whatever the policies and procedures they have taken, those are robust. Now, when it comes to about the certification, the views of their leader is that possibly for them certification is not to show, just to make a show up that yes, they have a certification of ISO 14000 or ISO 15001, but they want to use the certification to give the impression to the stakeholder that this is how seriously they are using this standard, how seriously they are adopting the standard in improving their business efficiency, business process, and also this is a proof what they are giving to the stakeholder that how standards are as per the compliance, and how the standard can be traced at the each point of the product life cycle. And they believe that certification is a route to the greater business efficiency. So, one of the example over here is that, so ISO 14000 is a generic standard for environment. So, even if they have adopted a standard of ISO 14000, which is generic standard for environment, addition to that, they have also taken ISO 50001, and ISO 50001 is specifically for the energy management. It focuses on cost benefits of using utilities more efficiently, focuses exclusively on energy, it requires an ongoing sustained improvement in energy efficiency, and a reduction in the greenhouse gas emission. So, even if 14001 or the family series of 14001 ISO talks about the environmental management, quantification of the greenhouse gas emission, also the impact, because it is a part of your life cycle, this life cycle is also part of ISO 14001 family. still they have taken an exclusive 50,001 to manage their energy specifically, so that it can increase the improvement in their energy efficiency and also reduce the greenhouse gas emission. Now, what is the benefits they have got, or in general what is the outcome, or what are the changes in the performance? So, there is a reduction in the companies by if you look at it, it is 750,000 pounds annual energy bill. Then the reduced water consumption by 20%, and when it comes to adopting ISO 50001, it provides the great understanding of energy consumption, specifically the energy consumption. 96% of the energy used as the factory was electricity, that is what they got from this entire energy management standard. And since they have adopted a ISO 15001, it gives a detailed analysis and also identified the potential cost saving across both the base and variable loads. And few of the intervention what they did because of this ISO 50001 is that fitting intelligent software to compressor to help them work more efficiently. And because of this ISO 50001, through the detailed analysis they plan their intervention, this is what the overall saving what they got. And finally, the recognition what they got because of this standard is that they won the Judges Special Award at the Best Factory Award in 2014, and BSI who helps in this giving the standards, provide direction, they have praised the company's success, especially with certification of ISO 50001, because you will not find many organizations apart from ISO 14001 series, they have also taken ISO 15001 and also adopting that, taking a certification for this. So, in this session what we have tried to understand that if there are standards, we know that there are different standards available, and also we know the benefit of the standards when we adopt this as a part of our environmental management system. But the bigger question is that why should organization, they should adopt this sustainability standard, whether it is reaping any benefits, because there is an investment associated with this standard. And through this case study we have seen that it, even if it requires investment, at the end of the day it gives the recognition, it gives the financial benefit, and also it gives the, at the end of it, it gives the sustainability benefit. Thank you.